Now here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. Indian stocks, bonds, and the rupee poised to climb after exit polls showed a landslide victory for Prime Minister Narendra Modi's party in general elections that concluded on Saturday. The predictions are likely to calm investors rattled by the recent stock market volatility, driven by concerns that Modi's alliance might fall short of his ambitious 400-seat target due to low voter turnouts in tight races in several states. Moving on, the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries, or OPEC Plus, agreeing to extend a voluntary production cut of 2.2 million barrels of crude oil a day into 2025. The cuts, first agreed in December, were due to expire at the end of this month. The move also comes as the group seeks to shore up the market amid tepid demand growth, high interest rates, and rising rival U.S. production. Brent crude oil prices have been trading near $80 a barrel in recent days, below what many OPEC Plus members need to balance their budgets. Still on oil, Saudi Arabia's oil giant Aramco's $12 billion share sale sold out shortly after the deal opened on Sunday. Bloomberg reports books were covered within the price range of 26.7 to 29 riyals, or just under $12 billion at the top end of the range. The deal could raise up to over $13 billion in a major test of international appetite for the kingdom's assets. In other news, AI darling NVIDIA eyeing to roll out its next-generation AI chip platform in 2026. The platform, which is called Rubin, will include new graphics and central processors as well as networking chips. The company also announced plans to release a new family of AI chips every year. Meanwhile, online fashion firm Shein reportedly taking a huge stride towards a London flotation that would value it at about 50 billion pounds or nearly $64 billion. Sky News reports the Chinese-founded firm valued at $66 billion is preparing to file a prospectus with Britain's Financial Conduct Authority as early as next week. The fast fashion company stepped up preparations for its London listing after its attempt to float itself in New York faced regulatory hurdles and pushback from U.S. lawmakers. And finally, Chinese tourists forecast to pump a record $938 billion into the mainland economy this year, topping pre-pandemic levels for the first time. A report by the World Travel and Tourism Council and Oxford Economics showed spending by domestic holiday makers is expected to be 11% higher than 2019 levels. Rainbow flags fill the streets of Thailand's capital for the annual Bangkok Pride Parade, which is more significant this year as the country inches closer to a landmark law. Thailand is poised to become the third location in Asia after Taiwan and Nepal and the first in Southeast Asia to legalize same-sex marriages. The final reading of the bill in the Senate is scheduled for June 18. If approved, it will be sent to the palace for the king's royal assent before it becomes law in 120 days. Pride Month celebrations have been endorsed by politicians, government agencies, and some of the country's biggest business conglomerates, which have become official partners or sponsors for the celebration.